Welcome to our mid-month climate and water outlook for April through to June 2021. I'm Dr. Andrew Watkins. In recent weeks, we've seen some good rainfall across parts of dry southern Western Australia due to thunderstorms early in March. In Central Australia, we've seen low-level heat waves, particularly in the Northern Territory and across into Western Australia. So what's driving our climate at the moment? Well, La Niña is clearly on the wane, having peaked in late December, early January. In the last couple of weeks, we've seen some of the ocean indices return to neutral conditions for the first time since August 2020. However, in the atmosphere, it's still clearly at La Niña levels, and so we are likely to see La Niña impacts for several more weeks to come. SAM, the MJO, and the IOD are all either weak or at neutral levels at the moment and not likely to play a big role in the coming season. However, climate change may play some role. Autumn to early winter rainfall has declined since the mid-1990s across southern Australia. So what does this mean for the outlook? Well, the rest of March is looking wetter than average for large parts of the country, and this could persist into April. However, the rest of the season may return to more average conditions as that La Niña declines. Overall, April through to June is looking likely to be wetter than average across the north and eastern parts of the country, but remember we are in that transition from La Niña to ENSO neutral conditions. In terms of stream flows, we're seeing for the first time above median stream flows likely in most locations. About 60% of locations having stream flows in that top tercile in the coming months. We are likely to see the drier conditions or low stream flows in southwest WA and southern parts of Queensland as well, where they haven't had as much rain recently. Remember though, for northern Australia and for eastern Australia, high soil moisture content and above average rainfall being likely means the risk of widespread flooding continues for the seasons ahead. So please be cautious if you see heavy rainfall in your areas. In terms of temperatures, away from the coast, it's likely to see average to below average daytime temperatures, whereas overnight, we are likely to see warmer than normal temperatures. This is fairly typical of a La Niña period. That's it for the mid-month outlook. I hope this is useful to you in your planning and decision-making. We'll see you next time.